legs!
This is a good start. Western Diamondback rattlesnake. Well, it didn't take long. It's like 6 o'clock in the morning, but we're racing with the sun because the heat can be very, very bad here.
Toxinologist Zoltan Takacs is in Arizona's Sonoran Desert. He's on the hunt for some of the world's most venomous creatures.
We're making the largest toxin libraries in the world. So I'm looking for rattlesnakes, spiders, scorpions, Gila monsters, all kinds of venomous creatures because they have a diversity of venom.
Venom has been evolving for millions of years to help some animals immobilize or kill their prey. And toxins are the poisonous substances that make a venomous bite so dangerous by targeting specific systems in the body to shut down. But Zoltan is instead using their deadly powers to make life-saving medications. By collecting toxins from different species, Zoltan can create a massive toxin library. Then he can screen these toxins to determine which ones will selectively target certain molecules in the human body. And these toxins may eventually be re-engineered to make brand new types of medications. So the more samples Zoltan can collect, the better.
Not bad. A different species, different toxins. The black-tailed rattlesnake.
This is the Gila monster. There's only a couple or so venomous species of lizards. This lizard is the source of one of the leading medication to treat diabetes. Wow, it's coming right from here.
And at night, a whole new crowd starts to appear.
This is very rare. This is a coral snake, the closest thing you can find in the US to a cobra. And also the venom, it's quite neurotoxic, but it's a beautiful animal.
And then there's the scorpion.
My new friend.
Scorpions' exoskeletons are biofluorescent, so they glow under a UV light.
If you don't like scorpions, don't bring a UV light to the desert because you will realize how many scorpions you have around you.
And at least one species produces a neurotoxin that targets cancer cells in the brain.
We're looking for the effect on brain cancer.
While snakes use their sharp fangs, scorpions rely on a pointy stinger at the end of their tails to inject venom. But catching these venomous creatures is only half of it. Zoltan now needs to extract a small sample of blood.
This is very dangerous because you're actually holding a highly venomous snake in your hand, the fangs just being a couple inches away from your hand.
Rattlesnake venom contains hundreds of different toxins, many of which directly attack the circulatory system of their victims. But in the lab, Zoltan and other scientists can re-engineer some of these same toxins to prevent circulatory problems, like heart attacks.
You're looking for the heart, and you see sometimes the scales are pulsating. And that's where you insert the needle. But you have to be very careful. You don't want to hurt the snake.
Done deal. This tube contains millions of years of evolutionary information, the genetic blueprint of one of the most lethal molecules in the universe. So we take back to the lab, and then we can recreate the same exact venom toxins what you find in the snake. This is why I came here.
Now I got what I need, and I can let the snake go free back the place where I caught it. I know many people don't really like snakes, but it doesn't matter whether you're a fan of snakes or you hate snakes. At the end of the day, they can save your life.